Guys, this is a slinger, and this is a Warframe grind video. Alright, so today we're going to do an episode of Excalibur Plays. And basically, I go into survivals as Excalibur, but Prime. See if anybody notices, see if we can find any hardcore. Giggity, 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 hardcore players that'll go half an hour plus. Also to see the reactions when they see Excalibur Prime. Most people probably think it's Excalibur. I would. I don't notice things like that, but other people do. We're going to go to Persto, which is the new survival on Deimos. Orbit
has been counting stars, operator. All accounted for.
And just hope for the best. Hope we get on a good team. Looks like we got players already, so see if they're cool guys. Maybe make some friends. Blazing fangs. All right. All right, got some energy here. Timed up. The EXcalibur. This is a Smite Infusion EXcalibur. Shield gating. I'm gonna drop me a air supply here. I think they can get destroyed. I think that's a thing, because I notice if I'm getting attacked when I drop one, nothing happens. Gotta find these other players here.
Looks like you could use a bit of life support. By your attack, that I am able to siphon valuable from near the strongholds. They will never see this fish coming. So when you are ready to return, the sanctum is waiting for you.
having a feeling that but I'm not dealing with your average players here. They might be actually pretty decent here. Poison Fang, is he leaving? There we go. That should have worked. Nobody was around me. Huh. Oh, shit. Looks like that guy didn't leave that wanted to, so that's good. Cherry picking.
Sending another capsule. You start growing trees, you know. Your hard work is really paying off. Looks like you could use a bit of life support.
Oh, nice. The open area. Oh, no. Shit. Somebody died.
Thank you.
I like finding areas. It's like a little hidden area with cool stuff in it.
Looks like you could use a bit of life support.
Murmur
will wish this to you.
Nice. We got a crew. We're at 26 minutes already. I know I've been quiet, but kind of just zoning out and like happy because I found actual people that will play Warframe. And this seems like a pretty good setup right here. Almost good enough I could just relax. Couple people, I guess, I've seen go down a couple times. I'm not sure if they were revived. I'm not sure if somebody revived, like, just hit the button, you know? I would say this is a total success with EXcalibur plays. EXcalibur Prime plays? Meet my new friend, Sizzle Chest, and his side companion. Silly guy.
Thank you.
Better check their stats. Oh yeah, Umbra Ape, he's doing pretty good. Reason is because if they both leave before me, I won't be able to check who they are or what they got on until I go to recent players. But this way, if you see one of your buddies on with me, you can say, hey, I saw you on YouTube. They really got to come out with more mods similar to Rolling Guard. It's, if you want some diversity, there is ones that do help with status. Get to extraction. I'll wait till I see if this guy's gonna leave. And after we get out of here, I'll go over my build too. This is not the same build I used to use back in my mod days. Although it is similar. Okay, so he was asking about the acolytes. It's almost every 5 minutes. It's not exactly. It's like, I think it's every four and a half minutes. after we get out of here, I'll in case he doesn't know, seems like it's like maybe his first time in Steel Path to any extent, not knowing what acolytes are. So I'll tell him, you know, like, save up the steel essence and you can buy cool stuff. Stool. You can buy stool with it. Cool stuff from Teshin. So. I'll message him under recent players because probably won't. I can't type and play at the same time. I know a lot of guys that can do that. They're like super fast. I love coming outside. This has actually worked out really good because this is one of my favorite things. Getting outside, doing a chokehold, and just sitting here and just abominating them. I mean, that's how you farm survivals, chokeholds. That's one technique. You can run around. You can face tank. Run around, but bottleneck it. Guy says, I'm sorry y'all, I feel useless. I said, no, have fun. And then the guy pointed arrow to what I said, you know. And then he said, well, at least I can give you guys a speed boost. And I said, perfect, you know. And the other guy agreed. So yeah, really nice. Nice. That's the thing about Warframe. Very good people. Mostly very good people, right? So that's what you want in a gaming community. Only thing probably that would be better is live streaming this, but the problem is I need to start live streaming. That's true.
work is really paid off. Seconds of life support remaining.
I hate those things. I got one of those things too. And it's so annoying when it pops out. I want to be able to remove it.
Inner Sanctum.
I'm gonna have to go pee pretty soon.
we're going to need a bigger sentence.
Thank you.
Level 300 with strangers. That is nice.
Thank you.
I think it's so cute, the newer guy. Not newer, I mean, he's in Steel Path. He's asking all questions, excited about stuff, you know. How do you get to Steel Path and not know all of this stuff, though? I don't know. Guess not everybody's a know-it-all, so... It's kind of nice. It's kind of refreshing, actually. Excuse me. Did not expect this to happen. Should have had like 3 energy drinks waiting. So I guess both these guys said they've never been to 400 before. And I just told them I'll post it on my YouTube. Wow, that blows me away. These guys have never been so... It's so cool that I get to be here for the first time that they hit level 400. And we're going to post it on YouTube. So these guys can like be like, yeah, see that? I went level 400. So that's awesome. That's part of the reason I love YouTube. I love Warframe, actually. YouTube, it's good because... you can do stuff, and you have proof. That's the one thing I like about YouTube. But Warframe, as a community, I think is one of the best communities in the gaming atmosphere, right? So...
Thank you.
Alright, so it's Umbral Ape and Poison Fangs. I think it's Fangs. I can't see the whole name the way they put the names. So this is really cool, and I don't want to stop because these guys have never been this level before. So for me to say, hey guys, I feel guilty. They're at 454. I gotta stay. I might have to buy diapers. this is what I try to talk people into doing, is coming outside and hanging out. And I got perfect strangers out here. Just, we're just bottlenecking and killing the shit out of these guys. This is awesome. And of course, dusty old EXcal Prime is doing just fine. Of course, he's not really dusty because I did change. I did update his shield gate and his setup. So it's more modernized as to what's going on. Whispers in the wall time with the different shards. And yeah, he's got a pretty modern setup, so he's no slouch. Yo, it's just too bad this video is going to be so long, but it's got to stay uncut. It is what it is. I'm going to have to upload it the way it is, and I really am excited about the way this turned out. Meeting nice people in Warframe, or at least nice enough to play with. And their first time going to level 400, so when we hit level 500, I know it'll be a pretty big deal. Because the way things are going, we're definitely going to 500. We're at 4, I just seen a 480, I think. 467, that guy. Under 20 minutes with strangers. That's awesome.
60 seconds of life support remaining.
You know, the only thing that'd be better if I was in my other account, because I have less steel essence over there. And I keep doing long runs in this account. I think I got a couple hundred over there. But here, like yesterday, I had over a thou. And then I bought my 25 Kuva from Teshin. You know, they got that limit. That's the first time that I saw Ape go down in 134 minutes, and I think he did the last gas, so I think he's good. The longer you play, the more, even with a good build, like that's the difference between Disruption, which I don't play very much, and like these survivals, when they go long distances, oh crap. You're more likely to have bad things happen over time because you get tired and you can't always play the perfect game, and it's a time thing with the survivals. Totally different. You can play a good game for 2 hours. Playing a perfect game for 8 hours is a whole different marathon. So people ask me why I do it. It's like running a marathon. If you've ever ran a marathon, I haven't, right? But I've done a lot of training in my life and a lot of discipline training and distance and endurance, and I have run long distance. First, you get the pain. You can't breathe. You get that, you know, aches all over your body, and you think you're gonna die, and then you keep going and you keep going. And then you get what's called the runner's high, right? So then you feel like a new burst of energy, and you can go on forever, and the aches and pains disappear. That's what doing an endurance run is kind of like. You get really beat up. I ain't gonna lie. You get beat up. But you can take breaks if you're solo, right? It's that same kind of discipline, though, that I get when I go to the gym, right? Boy, he really wants that gun. Hot take, it's not that great. Oh well. It's all what you want, right? $619, so these guys went, never been past 400, I think, before. At least that's what I know, they've never been past. Now they're at level 600. So, Umbral Ape, Poison Fang. Thank you for hanging out with OG Slinger. You're on Warframe Drive. I'll tell them we can go. One of them said that starting to lag a bit. What happens is when you're playing this long, your computer actually ends up getting hot. It's a lot for the computer, and it starts running slower, and I can feel it too. That's the nice thing about solo. You can, like, give your computer a break. I am not even the host, but I think that the internet's fine. It's just that everybody's computer is probably punching overtime.
suckers!
Alright, so he's saying he wanted to stay to 150 minutes. Alright. I'm weak but not dumb. Awesome. I'd say he did great. I used to tell my friends, I think in the like second or third clan I was ever in at Warframe, we started getting good, but not like good, right? But like proficient. And I'd always be like, dude, there's stuff that we don't know about Warframe. I mean, people go to level 9,000 and shit. And my buddies are like, you think? And I'm like, yeah, dude, there's stuff we don't even know. And I was right. So weird. But it's not the stuff you don't know, it's the stuff you don't put together. Right? It's the fine detail thread things, right? The interactions. So I always try to keep my interactions pretty simple. But you can still be effective, even if your interactions are simple, you can be effective. You don't have to live a meme on Warframe. too many people try to. But you can still have everything working together and be effective without being a joke. So, yeah. Yeah, some guys on Warframe live for that extreme build and overthink the shit out of their stuff. And dude, actually, there's a lot of guys like that on Warframe, but there's nothing wrong with that. It's just not my style, right? Those guys are good to have as buddies because they'll think of stuff a little bit different than you. They'll be able to, you know... Or maybe you're that guy, and like, you'd make a good buddy for me, because I don't want to be that guy. So. Oh. Where is... There we go. Well, guys, thank you for spending time with the OG Slinger. I gotta tell him.
One must make the best of things.
Ah, no. All right, well, they left, but I was going to say I was going to post it up on YouTube, but whoever the host was wasn't waiting around. So, all right, guys, that's my video. Get out there and grind. I have.